Game two between the Oilers and Ducks in Anaheim. Edmonton scored four times in the third period of game one en route to a 5-3 win. Leon Draisaitl with 4 points in the victory. He has at least one marker in all six games against Anaheim this season. We go to the Honda Center.
There's McDavid off the left wing, trying to get by Josh Manson. He's taken out hard, and the puck is poked loose. A long shot, they score! Andrej Sekera blasted a shot from just inside the blue line, and the Edmonton Oilers have scored a minute and 5 seconds in.
There you go, the first shot on goal. Just a bomb that goes right underneath the blocker of Gibson.
That's a dozen different players have now scored goals for the Oilers in the playoffs. Got Getzlaf still on the ice with him out front. Montour jumps in off the blue line. Getzlaf has a look for Cogliano right off the bench. He shoots and a great save by Talbot.
Look at the positioning there of Cam Talbot, just in great position.
Power play goals in just 5 games in the playoffs. McDavid on the ice, he didn't know where the puck was. Getzlaf got it first. Kessler in front, stopped by Talbot. There's another big save.
Under the arm or over the blocker, and Talbot came across and caught him.
Pouliot dishes off. Teyarnay couldn't get the pass. Here's a two-on-two as Wagner throws the puck in front. Getzlaf stopped by Talbot. Just kicked out his left leg. Boy, he's made some beauties early on. Sekera, another good stick by Vermette. Couldn't get out though. Here's Eberle, walks in to the front of the net, score! Tipped in by Patrick Maroon. A power play goal and Edmonton's out front 2-0.
As Pouliot's coming hard to the net, Eberle gets it towards there and right off the skate, and then the stick of Gibson and up and over the arm of outstretched Gibson. He even dropped his stick trying to grab it.
Ed Tricassi to try and get it out against a pinching Lindholm. He threw the puck at the net, and an alert Talbot steered the puck away, and there's a penalty coming on the play. And it looks like Jarrett Bull got a stick in the face, bumps it back. Fowler won't shoot again. Silverberg takes over. He walks in. His pass is in a skate. Kessler kept that alive. Fowler. Silverberg shoots. He scores! 20 seconds after the penalty, and the Oilers didn't touch the puck, and the Ducks are back in it.
Silverberg through traffic, and that second delay there. Silverberg's got his head up the entire time, make sure that he gets it to the only area that it can get by, the two bodies in front and in the back of the net.
Too many Ducks, they ganged it again and got the puck back. Silverberg to the blue line, Fowler shot at the post! Tipped off the post by Patrick Eaves.
Perfectly done by Eaves, but off the right pad of Talbot and in a position off the post.
Antoine Vermette is 13-5 in the faceoff circle. Make that 13-6. Well, they could give him a win there because Eaves got the puck to the blue line. Fowler shoots another goal post behind Talbot.
The sound of the post is a good feeling. You hope that you don't hear the roar of the crowd, and he didn't.
First back, Chris Russell up the board. Silverberg kept it in. Hooked to the front of the net. Here's Fowler with a shot. Blocked in front. Raquel had a great chance. And the puck comes loose. 6 seconds to go. Battle up the boards. The puck gets out. Milan Lucic is after it. And the Oilers hang on and take a 2-0 lead in the series with a 2-1 win over the Anaheim Ducks.
The Oilers go into Anaheim and win both games on the road to start the series, taking a 2-0 lead. Edmonton wins despite being outshot 40-23. Cam Talbot, another stellar postseason performance, stopping 39 of 40 shots. Patrick Maroon now has 4 points in his last 4 games, including the game-winning goal in Game 2. The Oilers go home with a 2-0 series lead, Game 3 in Edmonton on Sunday.